हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द यूपीएससी टाइम्स। फ्रेंड्स, आज हम इकोनॉमिक्स क्लास 10th की बुक को डिस्कस करने जा रहे हैं। इसका चैप्टर नंबर 2 तक हम कवर कर चुके हैं ऑलरेडी, एंड आज हम इसका चैप्टर नंबर 3 पढ़ेंगे। चैप्टर का नाम है यहाँ पर मनी एंड क्रेडिट। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं आज का चैप्टर। मनी एज ए मीडियम ऑफ एक्सचेंज and the use of money span a very large part of our everyday life. Look around you and you would easily able to identify several transactions involving money in any single day. Can you make a list of these? In many of these In many of these transactions, goods are being brought and sold with the use of money, and in some of these transactions, services are being exchanged with money. For some, there might be any actual transfer of money taking place now, but promise to pay money in later. Have you ever wondered why transactions are made in money? The reason is simple. A person holding money can easily exchange for any commodity or services that he or she might want. तो जो पैसे से कोई भी person किसी भी चीज़ को purchase कर सकता है, कभी भी किसी भी चीज़ को exchange कर सकता है using money, and thus everyone prefers to receive payment in money. इसलिए हर कोई money में जो payment है उसको लेना चाहेगा. And then exchange of money for things that they want. Take the case of shoe manufacturer, and he want to sell the shoes in the market and buy wheat. And the shoe manufacturer first will exchange the shoes he has produced for money, and then exchange the money for wheat. तो पहले तो वो अपने शूज़ को बेच के पैसे कमाएगा जो भी उसने प्रोड्यूस किया है, एंड उसके बाद जो है वो अपने लिए वीट खरीदेगा. एंड इमेजिन हाउ मच मोर difficult it would be if the shoe manufacturer had directly exchanged the shoes for wheat without the use of money, and he would have to look for wheat and growing farmers who are not only want to sell wheat but also want to buy the shoes in exchange. That is, both parties have to agree to sell and buy each other's commodity. This is known as the double consequence of bond. And what a person desire to sell exactly what he wishes to buy in a barter system where goods are directly exchanged without the use of money. तो पहले क्या होता था, बार्टर सिस्टम में जो गुड्स थे, मतलब जैसे भी किसी को सपोज गेहूँ बेचने हैं और उसको चावल खरीदने हैं, तो वो दोनों गेहूँ और चावल का आपस में लेन देन कर लेंगे, तो उसको बोलते हैं वाटर सिस्टम. गुड्स से गुड्स को खरीदना एक तरीके से. एंड विदाउट एक्सचेंज विदाउट द यूज ऑफ मनी. एंड डबल कोइंसिडेंस ऑफ वांट इज essential for future, and in contrast a economy where money is used as money by providing the crucial and intermediate step eliminates the needs of double coincidence of want, and it is no longer necessary for the shoe manufacturer to for farmers who will buy these shoes at the same time सैलिव, पीट, ऑल हैज टू डू फाइंड वायर फॉर द शूज एंड वंस ही हैज एक्सचेंज्ड द शूज फॉर मनी ही गेट He can purchase wheat or any other commodity in the market, and since money acts as an intermediate in the exchange process, it is called as the medium of exchange. तो यहाँ पे टर्म इम्पोर्टेंट हो जाती है. मॉडर्न फॉर्म्स ऑफ मनी. We have seen that money is something that can act as a medium of exchange in transactions. Before introduction of coins, a variety of object was used as money. For example, since the very early age, Indians used grains and cattle as money. So पहले के टाइम पे लोग जो ग्रेन्स अनाज होता था और केटल होती थी उनके बदले में एक्सचेंज करते थे चीज़ों को. एंड देयर आफ्टर केम टू यूज ऑफ द मेटेलिक कॉइन्स. उसके बाद मेटेलिक कॉइन्स आए, गोल्ड, सिल्वर, कॉपर कॉइन्स, ए फेज विच कंटिन्यू टू वेल इनटू द लास्ट सेंचुरी. करेंसी. Modern form of money include currency, paper notes and coins, unlike the things that were used as money earlier. Modern currency is note. Demand deposits offer another interesting facility. It is the facility which lends the essential characteristics of money, that of a medium of exchange. You would have heard of the payment being made payment being made by checks of instead of cash, or payment through the check. The payer who has the account with the bank make out of the check for a specific amount, and a check is a paper instructing the bank to pay a specific amount for the person's account to the person in the whose name the check has been issued. तो ये चेक होता है ऐसा, जैसे ये इसमें अकाउंट नंबर होते हैं जो पे कर रहा है उसके, एंड यहाँ पे जो नेम वगैरह अमाउंट वगैरह भरा जाता है ऐसे. तो आप देख सकते चेक होता है, बैंक के कोड होते हैं इसमें, अकाउंट नंबर होता है, चेक नंबर होता है, एंड कोडिंग होती है जो बैंक के द्वारा की गई होती है. Thus we see that the demand deposits share the essential features of the money, and the facility of check against the demand deposit make it possible to directly settle payment without the use of cash, since demand deposits are accepted widely as a means of payment along with currency. They constitute money in modern economy. You must remember the role that the bank play here, but for the banks there would be no demand deposits and no payment by the checks against these deposits. The modern form of money and currency and deposit are closely linked to the to the working of the modern banking system. Loan activities of bank. Let us take the story of bank further. What do the bank do with the deposits which they accept from the public? There is an interesting mechanism at work here. Bank keeps only a small proportion for their deposits as cash with themselves. For example, banks in India these days hold about 15% of their deposit as cash. And जो बैंक है यहाँ पे जो 15% डिपॉजिट को अपने पास रखती है, एंड दिस इज कीप्ड एज ए प्रोविजन टू पे डिपॉजिटर्स हु माइट कम टू विदड्रॉ मनी. और जो भी इसलिए रखा जाता है क्योंकि कोई लोग विदड्रॉ करने वाले जाए तो वहाँ बैंक के पास पैसे होने चाहिए उनको देने के लिए, इसलिए 15% को अपने पास रखते हैं. बैंक विदड्रॉ फ्रॉम द बैंक on the given day, and since on the particular day or only some of its many depositors come to withdraw cash, the bank is able to manage with the cash. The bank use major portion of the deposit to extend loan. There is a huge demand of loans for the various economic activities. We shall read more about this in the following sections. Banks makes use of the deposits to meet the loan requirement of the people. And जो बाकी का पैसा होता है बैंक लोन भी देता है लोगों को, जिससे लोगों की लोन की रिक्वायरमेंट पूरी होती है. इन दिस वे बैंक मीडिएट बिटवीन दी दोज हु हैव सरप्लस फंड एंड दोज who need of the fund. तो बैंक एज ए मीडिएटर वर्क करता है, जिसके पास ज़्यादा पैसा है उससे कम पैसे वाले को, मतलब सरप्लस मनी को, उधर एज ए लोन के रूप में देना ऑफ दिस फंड दी बोरोवर्स, जिनको हम बोरोवर्स बोलते हैं. एंड banks चार्ज ए हायर इंटरेस्ट bank चार्ज higher interest rate on the loan than what they offer on deposit. The difference between the what is charged from the borrowers and what is paid from the depositors, the main source of the income. तो जो बैंक का जो इनकम का सोर्स होता है यही सोर्स है बैंक के इनकम का, कि लोग पैसा जमा कराते हैं बैंक, उनको कुछ अमाउंट को 15% अमाउंट को अपने पास रखता है, एंड जो बाकी का सरप्लस अमाउंट है उसको वो और लोगों को जो है लोन देता है एज ए उनकी नीड होती है. तो उनसे वो हाई इंटरेस्ट रेट चार्ज करता है एंड डिपॉजिटर्स के कंपेरिजन में, तो वहाँ से वो जो है बैंक की अर्निंग होती है. जैसे डिपॉजिट करवाते, पीपल मेक डिपॉजिट्स एंड पीपल मेक विड्रॉ एंड गेट इंटरेस्ट. तो लोग बैंक में पैसा जमा कराते हैं एंड पैसा वापस मिलता है उनको विद इंटरेस्ट. लेकिन ये इंटरेस्ट एंड बैंक लोगों को लोन देता है पैसे, और फिर लोग उनको रीपे करता है बैंक को पैसों को विद इंटरेस्ट. तो जो इंटरेस्ट इधर डिपॉजिटर्स का ये कम होता है, एंड जो बैंक रिपे करते हैं बैंक को जो बोरोवर्स, वो इंटरेस्ट इसके कंपेरिजन में ज़्यादा होता है. तो यहाँ से बैंक की अर्निंग होती है. टू डिफरेंट क्रेडिट सिचुएशंस. ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन्स इन आवर डे टू डे एक्टिविटीज इन्वॉल्व क्रेडिट in some form of or the other. Credit loan refers to the an agreement in which the leader is in the sorry lender supplies the borrower with the money and the goods or services in returns for the promises for future payment. Let's see how credit works through the following example. तो आप एक बार ये जो एग्जाम्पल दी हुई है इसको एक बार रीड कर सकते हैं. चलो इसको रीड करते हैं. फेस्टिवल सीजन. इट इज़ अ फेस्टिवल सीजन टू मंथ फ्रॉम नाउ एंड नाउ एंड द शू मैन्युफैक्चरर सलीम हैज रिसीव्ड ऑर्डर फ्रॉम लार्ज ट्रेडर्स इन दी फॉर 3000 पेयर ऑफ शूज टू बी डिलीवर्ड इन ए मंथ टाइम. To complete production on time, Salim had to hire a few more workers for sticking and posting work, and he has to purchase the raw material to meet the expense. And Salim obtained loan from the two sources. First, he asked the leather supplier to supply leather, and he promised to pay him later. Second, he obtained the loan in a cash from the large trader in as advance payment for 1000 pairs of the shoes with a promise to deliver the whole order by the end of the month. And at the end of the month, Salim is able to deliver the order, make good profit and repay the money of the borrowed. In the case Salim obtained credit to meet the working capital needs of production, and the credit helped him to meet the ongoing expenses of production, complete production on time, and thereby increase his earning. Credit therefore plays a vital and positive role in this situation. In rural areas, the main demand for the credit is for to crop production involved in the considerable cost of seeds, fertilizer, pesticides, water and electricity, repair of the equipment, etc. तो ये सारे crop production में सारी चीज़ें लगती है. And there is a minimum stretch of the 3 or 4 months between the time of when the farmers buy these input and when they sell the crop. Farmers usually take crop loan at the beginning of the season and repay the loan after harvest. Repayment of the loan is crucially dependent on the income for farming. In Swapna's case, the failure of the crop made loan repayment impossible, and she had to sell part of the land of repay the loan. Credit, instead of helping Swapna improving her earning, and left her worse off. And this is an example of what is commonly called the debt trap. And credit in this case pushes the borrower into a situation from which recovery is very painful. In one situation, credit help to increase the earning of, and therefore the person in better to off than before. The another situation, because of the crop failure, credit pushes the person into debt trap and repay her loan. She has to sell a portion of her land, and she is clearly much of worse than before. And whether credit would be useful or not therefore depends on risk of the situation and whether there is some support in case of loss. Terms of credit. Every loan agreement specifies an interest rate which its borrowers must to pay to the lenders along with the repayment of principal, and in addition to lender may demand collateral security against loan. Collateral is an asset that the borrower owns, and such as land, buildings, vehicle, livestock, deposits with the bank, and uses the guarantee of the lender until the loan is repaid. If the borrower fails to repay the loans, the lender has the right to sell the asset of the collateral. तो यहाँ पे जब कोई इंसान मतलब एक तरीके से गिरवी रखता है अपनी चीज़ों को एंड बैंक से लोन लेता है, बैंक से या किसी से भी, तो मतलब वहाँ पे या तो वो फिक्स टाइम पीरियड में या तो पैसे रिटर्न कर देगा, नहीं तो जिससे लोन लिया है वो उसके एसेट को जो उसने रखा है उसके पास उसको वो बेच देगा, उसको बेच के वो पैसे वसूल कर लेगा एक तरीके से. ऑब्टेन पेमेंट. प्रॉपर्टी सच एज लैंड टाइटल्स, डिपॉजिट्स विद बैंक, लाइव स्टॉक एंड सम कॉमन एग्जांपल ऑफ द कलेक्टर आर यूज फॉर बोरइंग. इंटरेस्ट रेट, कलेक्ट्रल एंड डॉक्यूमेंटेशन रिक्वायरमेंट एंड द मोड ऑफ रिपेमेंट टुगेदर कंप्राइज व्हाट इज द कॉल्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ क्रेडिट, एंड द टर्म्स ऑफ क्रेडिट वेरी सब्सटेंशियली वन क्रेडिट अरेंजमेंट टू अनदर, एंड दिस मे वेरी डिपेंडिंग ऑन द नेचर ऑफ द लेंडर एंड बोरोअर. द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन will provide example of the varying terms of credit in the different credit agreement. फॉर्मल सेक्टर क्रेडिट इन इंडिया. वी हैव सीन इन द अबव एग्जांपल्स दैट पीपल ऑब्टेन लोन फ्रॉम द वेरियस सोर्सेज. तो लोग है वो वेरियस सोर्सेज से लोन लेते हैं, एंड द वेरियस टाइप ऑफ द लोन्स can be conventionally grouped as a formal sector loan and informal sector loans. Among the former sector loans from banks and cooperatives, the informal lenders include money lenders, traders, employers, relatives and friends, etc. Graph 1, you can see that the various sources of credit in rural household in India is more credit coming from the formal sector or the informal sector. जैसे 33% तो money lender से जा रहा है, 1% landlord से जा रहा है, commercial bank से कितना credit जा रहा है 25%, cooperative society और bank से 25%, एंड अदर नॉन इंस्टीट्यूशनल एजेंसी 2%, गवर्नमेंट 1%, एंड रिलेटिव्स एंड फ्रेंड्स 8%। The Reserve Bank of India supervises the functioning of the formal sources of loans from instance we have seen that the bank maintain a minimum cash balance out of the deposits they receive the RBI monitor the banks in actually maintaining cash balance similarly The RBI sees that the banks give loans not just for profit-making businesses and traders, but also to small cultivation as small-scale industries, to small borrowers, etc. Periodically, banks have to submit information to the RBI on how much they are lending to whom and at what interest rate. There is no own organization which supervises the credit activities of lenders and informal sectors. They can lend at whatever interest rate they chose. No one to stop them using unfair means of to get the money back. And compared to the formal sectors, formal lenders, most of the informal lenders charges much higher interest rate on loan. जो informal means से हम जो पैसा लेते हैं तो वहाँ पर ज़्यादा interest rate हमसे charge की जाती है. Thus the cost of the borrower of the informal loan is much higher. Higher cost of the borrowing means a larger part of the earning of the borrowers and is used to repay the loan. Hence, borrowers have to less income they left they themselves as we saw them Shamlal and Sonpur. In certain cases, the higher interest rate for the borrowing can mean that the amount of to be repaid is greater than the income of the borrower. This could lead to increasing debt, and as we saw for Rama Sonpur and debt trap, also people who might wish to start an enterprise by borrowing may not be so because of the higher cost of borrowing, and for these reasons, bank and cooperatives societies needs to lend more, and this would lead to a higher income, and many people could then borrow cheaply for a variety of needs, and they could grow up to do business, set up small scale industries, and they could set up the new industries or trade in goods. Cheap and affordable credit is crucial for the country development. Formal and informal credit, who gets what? Graph 2 shows that the importance of the formal and informal sources credit for people in urban areas. The people are divided into four groups: the poor and poor to rich, the as shown in the figure. You can see the 85% of the loan is taken by the poor household in the urban areas and are from informal sources. and compared to this with rich urban household, what you found only 10% of their loans are from informal sources, while 90% of they're from formal sectors. And a similar pattern is also found in the rural areas. The rich household are the availing cheap credit from the formal lenders, whereas the poor household have to pay a large amount of borrowing. What does this suggest? First of all, the formal sector, the meet only about the half of the total credit needs to the rural people, and the remaining credit needs are met from the informal sources. Most loan from the informal lenders carry much high interest rate and do little to increase the income of the borrowers. तो यहाँ पे जो informal lenders होते हैं वो ज़्यादा interest चार्ज करते हैं, and thus it is necessary that the banks and cooperatives increase their lending, particularly in the rural areas, so that the dependence of the informal sources of the credit reduces. Secondly, while the former sector's loans need to be expanded, it is also necessary that everyone receives the loan. तो जो यहाँ पे जो भी बैंक्स है, कॉरपोरेटिव्स है, इनको मतलब ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा जो अपनी जो रूरल एरिया में हो वहाँ पे उनकी लैंड वहाँ पे इंक्रीज करनी चाहिए लैंडिंग, क्योंकि जिससे एवरीवन कैन रीच टू चीप इंटरेस्ट रेट लोन्स. एंड सेकेंडली वाइल इनफॉर्मल सेक्टर्स loans need to expand, it is also necessary that everyone receives the loans. तो हर कोई वहाँ पर ईजिली फिर लोन्स को जो है रिसीव कर पाएगा. एंड एट प्रजेंट इट इज़ रिचर हाउस होल्ड एंड हु रिसीव्स फॉर्मल क्रेडिट, वेयर एज द पुअर हैव टू डिपेंड ऑन द इनफॉर्मल सेक्टर. तो अगेन जो पुअर पीपल है जो इनफॉर्मल सेक्टर पर ज़्यादा डिपेंड रहते हैं. And it is important to that the formal credit distributed more equally so that the poor can benefit from the cheaper loans. Self-help groups for the poor. In the previous section, we have seen that the poor households are still डिपेंडेंट इन इनफॉर्मल सोर्सेज ऑफ द क्रेडिट. जैसा कि हमने पिछले सेक्शन में देखा था कि जो कैसे जो पुअर हाउस होल्ड है वो इनफॉर्मल सोर्सेज पर ज़्यादा डिपेंडेंट रहते हैं फॉर द ऑफ द क्रेडिट. एंड वाई इज इट सो? बैंक्स आर नॉट प्रेजेंट एवरीवेयर इन रूरल इंडिया. जो बैंक्स है वो सब जगह प्रेजेंट नहीं है इन द रूरल इंडिया में. And even when they are present, getting a loan for the bank is much more difficult than taking a loan from informal sector. As we saw, mega banks loans require proper documents, collaterals. Absence of collaterals is one of the major reasons which prevents the poor from getting bank loan. Informal lenders such as money lenders and the other end know borrowers personally and hence are often willing to give some importance without collateral. offers amount interest into the file, repayment schedules, etc. Also, it is the group which is responsible for repayment of the loan in case of the non-repayment of the loan by any one member is followed up by seriously by other members of the group. Because of this future, banks are willing to lend, and poor women then organize SSGs even though they have no collateral as such. The SSGs has helped borrowers. The problem of the lack collateral, they can get timely loans for the variety of purposes and at a reasonable interest rate. Moreover, the SSGs and the building blocks of the organization rural poor. Not only does the help of the women tend to become financially self-reliant, and the regular meetings of the groups provide a platform to discuss the and act as a variety of social issues such as health and nutrition, domestic violence, etc. समिंग अप, तो इस चैप्टर में हमने देखा कि मॉडर्न फॉर्म में जो मनी है उसमें मनी एंड हाउ दे आर लिंक्ड विद द बैंकिंग सिस्टम. वन साइड डिपोजिटर्स हु कीप मनी इन द बैंक, ऑन द अदर साइड बोरोअर्स हु टेक लोन्स फ्रॉम द बैंक. मतलब एक साइड से डिपोजिटर्स होते हैं वो जो पैसे को जमा करवाते हैं बैंक में, और दूसरे मतलब जो बोरोवर्स होते हैं जो लोन लेते हैं बैंक से. द इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज रिक्वायर लोन और क्रेडिट. क्रेडिट एज वी सॉ कैन बी ए पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट और सर्टेन सिचुएशन मेक्स द बोरोवर्स वर्स ऑफ. क्रेडिट इज अवेलेबल फ्रॉम ए वेराइटी ऑफ सोर्सेज. दीज कैन बी आइदर फॉर्मल सोर्सेज और इनफॉर्मल सोर्सेज. Terms of credit vary substantially between formal and informal lenders. At present, it is the richer household who receive credit from formal sources, whereas the poor have depend on the informal sources. And it is essential that the formal sector credit increases so that the dependence of more expensive informal sectors get a much greater share of the formal loans from the bank, cooperatives, societies, etc. And both these steps are important for development. इसी के साथ हमारा चैप्टर समाप्त होता है. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. अगर आप हमारा चैनल पसंद आया तो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब दिस वीडियो. थैंक यू.